I'm sorry, but to me, Bray Wyatt feels like a jobber type of mid-card WWE champion. And nothing anybody says in the comments or tweets at me or does videos about is going to change that fact. Too many years of him losing marquee matchups time after time after time to big spots. Too many times of inconsistent featuring and booking. Too much of the same in terms of the way he's featured. The lack of progression and growth in the character, change in the character. You just get to the point where you just don't really care about him. And that's the way I got to him, which is a shame. Because like I said, in theory, there are a lot of things about Bray Wyatt that I really, really should like. And deep down, I'm secretly rooting for him to prove me wrong. I want Bray Wyatt to be that type of dude. But we have to be honest here. 3.5 years after he really came on the scene, you know, does he really feel like a type of guy that should be carrying a world title? And this speaks to the larger problem of just because you could put anybody in a spot and make them world champion does not mean they are world championship material, nor should they be world championship material. And part of what hurts the product, on top of the fact that each Raw and SmackDown show has a world champion, a tag team champion, a women's champion, and so on and so forth. You got so many champions, you can't keep anybody anything straight. And instead of it elevating more people, it actually elevates fewer people because it sucks everybody into feeling kind of more of the same and confusing the audience. It's just in general, you look at this and you say, a world champion should be the type of guy that you build the company around. And there are too few of those guys in WWE, but too many of them actually get that strap, actually get that spot and that opportunity. And it just devalues the championship. It devalues the main event scene. It doesn't get guys over. And it helps put the company in the damn position it is from an on-screen creative standpoint. But nonetheless, that's the direction this company has gone. But again, I'm not changing my mind about it just because he's champion now and that's supposed to be great and awesome. No. You know, I'm just sorry. No, it doesn't. But a lot of you have used the defense mechanism talking about the story involving Randy Orton and Bray Wyatt as being a justification for Bray Wyatt really breaking out of his shell and really justifying that spot for him and justifying that he should have a featured world title match at WrestleMania. Talking about the quality of the story makes up for it, the quality of the opponent, the quality of a lot of different factors. And again, I just say bullshit to that. I'm sorry. Because I think about it this way. With Randy Orton, when he joined the Wyatt family, this has always been kind of a square peg in a round hole and really just fucking odd. Randy Orton joined the Wyatt family for reasons that are really unbeknownst to me from a creative standpoint. And we did absolutely nothing to change his look, change his style, change his work, change his mic work, change anything about his character whatsoever during his time with the Wyatt family. Why would I ever get bought into Randy Orton actually being a member of the Wyatt family and actually being controlled by Bray Wyatt in any way if you've never done anything to actually effectively assimilate him into the Wyatt family collective, like that Borg reference from Star Trek? But in all seriousness, you didn't even treat him like he was the black sheep of the Wyatt family, because that's a gimmick you've already used before. You just threw him in there. It felt fucking random and weird. So it's hard to get bought in on this ever being a real viable story if you've done really nothing, and let's face it, you've done nothing really, to ever change anything about the way Orton works or looks, his style, nothing. Now granted, that's because the best he can grow out is a construction worker beard, but you could have changed his ring attire, you could have changed a lot of things about him, and they did nothing. And ultimately, him joining the Wyatt family to me during his time in the group added no real new depth or dimension or purpose to his character. It honestly did nothing for the Bray Wyatt character and the Wyatt family shtick. You did nothing to shake up the shtick. It was the same. You've got a new member. You know, you've got arguably the biggest name and most important member you've ever had in the family, and you run things the same way. That doesn't make any sense. And ultimately, from an Orton character standpoint, it makes no sense because at the end of the day, if he's mad about a spot or he's mad about this or mad about that from a kayfabe standpoint, why the hell would you align yourself with a guy that's never won a world championship and has very few marquee wins? He couldn't ultimately prevail over The Undertaker. He couldn't ultimately prevail over John Cena. He couldn't ultimately prevail over Roman Reigns. So that's the guy you want to fucking align yourself with? I mean, from a kayfabe standpoint, how stupid does that sound? You would think you would want to align yourself like Chris Jericho did with Kevin Owens, because Kevin Owens was the Universal Champion. His first ever pay-per-view in WWE, he beat the god face of the company, John Cena. Not god, there's a difference, ugh, but the god face. Why wouldn't you align yourself with Seth Rollins? Or Triple H? Or Roman Reigns? All of these people that are at the top, all of these people that have marquee signature wins, all of these people that have actually won big matches, had world titles. Why the hell wouldn't he associate himself with John Cena then? It's just ridiculous. Why the hell would a Randy Orton have any interest in joining in the Wyatt family instead of trying to go out and get revenge for what happened at, what was it, SummerSlam, what Brock Lesnar did to him with busting him open the hard way? Why the fuck wouldn't he want revenge again? It's just dumb. The whole concept of Orton joining the Wyatt family was dumb. And based off of the fact that they never really shook up Orton and they never really changed him, especially from an appearance standpoint, to actually assimilate him into that Wyatt family collective. There we go, Borg reference again, number two. How the fuck am I ever going to get bought into this? And how the fuck does that make for good storytelling? But further on, we get to that point in time where we get to the Royal Rumble. And we have Randy Orton win the Royal Rumble. Here's what I don't understand about this. At this moment in time, if Orton's a member of the Wyatt family and Bray Wyatt is that cult-like figure, that cult-like leader, why in the bluest of blue fucks would WWE not book it in a way to actually make it seem like Bray Wyatt, actually had some mental control over... Bray Wyatt had some mental control over fucking Randy Orton, and as a result, he either A, prevents Randy Orton from entering the Rumble as one of the 30 contestants anyways, or B, once Orton gets in there, the whole purpose is to work with Bray Wyatt the entire time, eliminate everybody up to and including Roman Reigns, and when it's down to the last two, Randy Orton either allows Wyatt to eliminate him or he eliminates himself so that way Bray Wyatt gets that Royal Rumble win. From a character standpoint, why would that make any fucking sense? Why would Bray Wyatt want something like this to happen where one of his underlings is in a position where they could win the Royal Rumble? That's stupid, and it's stupid because the WWE books it that fucking way. Why wouldn't his only purpose to be in the Rumble to make sure that Bray Wyatt wins? If you are the leader of a group and you're acting like a demagogue or you're acting like a cult leader, it's all about you. It's about your ego. And everything's supposed to funnel through you. If you were in that position, why the hell would you want to have it in any way, shape, or form where Randy Orton could potentially win that Rumble? Everything about it should be about exerting a certain level of mind control to ensure that you're the one that gets that spot. That's why you have this guy associated with you. Again, it's stupid. But then even more so than that, if you were just going to go on and have Bray Wyatt win the WWE Championship at the Elimination Chamber anyways, why didn't you have Randy Orton in that match to either A, get involved from outside interference to make sure that Bray Wyatt won, or B, make sure that Randy Orton was there so that way him and Bray Wyatt could tag team the entire fucking match, so that way you got to a point in time where it's again to the last two, and Randy Orton could either walk out and forfeit and Bray Wyatt wins, or we do some finger poke of doom, voluntary lay down shit. If you want to actually get Bray Wyatt over as a cult leader, as a guy that can actually affect mental control on people, play mind games with people, imagine the mind game of a former, 12, 13 time world champion having to lay down flat in the middle of the ring for freaking Bray Wyatt. So of course the WWE doesn't do that. Furthermore, if you're Randy Orton and you're really trying to have him get under Wyatt's skin and you're going to go with this breakup, then another option, even though it's dumb, would be if Orton kept the Rumble spot, why not have him cost Bray Wyatt the title? Like, and you don't want this. Why not furthermore fuck the whole thing the night after Royal Rumble, pull some Andre DiBiase shit, and just have Randy Orton give his opportunity to Bray Wyatt? I don't know. It's just fucking confusing. And to me, the WWE made it even more confusing for me, made it even more ridiculous, because at the end of the day, to me, what they did was they took a WrestleMania World title match and made it about setting up SmackDown main events. Not the way it should be, which are SmackDown main events this time of year that should be setting up to feature WrestleMania matches. And here's what I mean. We get to the point in time where Randy Orton, after Bray Wyatt wins the Elimination Chamber, He gives up his spot, so to speak. He says, if you're the champion, I'm not going to face you. And I'm not going to keep that opportunity that I got from winning the Royal Rumble. So then we sit there and have a battle royal to determine a new number one contender, which ends in a crappy tie between Luke Harper and AJ Styles, where at no point in time is Randy Orton involved in any way, especially you would think with a former Wyatt family member like Luke Harper involved, you would think everything about that match would be about keeping Luke Harper away or trying to interfere in such a way where nobody is a decisive winner here. But again, they didn't do that. It's dumb. So you have a number one contender battle royal, just so that way you could set up to a match the next week between Luke Harper and AJ Styles. Just so that way, if you insist on going with this Wyatt family shit for the WWE title at WrestleMania, instead of logically just shoehorning Luke Harper in there, which has a lot of fit, would be a really nice chance for him to get an opportunity to shine at the biggest stage of them all. You freaking have AJ Styles win, and you just go all types of fucking awkward here, and you just basically cast Luke Harper aside, even though there was more tension between a Luke Harper and a Randy Orton than there was a Brandy Orton and a Bray Wyatt. There's more tension, honestly, between a Luke Harper and a Bray Wyatt, and frankly, furthermore, if we're going from a Wyatt family standpoint, it would make much more logical sense from a historical aspect to have a Luke Harper win the Royal Rumble if you must. Luke Harper be the number one contender. Luke Harper to go on one-on-one to face Bray Wyatt at WrestleMania for the title, because at the end of the day, it feels like a jobber world title match anyways. Why not at least plug in something that makes much more logical sense, that has a lot more history and backdrop and background to it? But instead, the WWE tries to awkwardly set this in. So we have Orton give up his Rumble spot, or his opportunity that he won at the Rumble, which is dumb, because at the end of the day, if you're Bray Wyatt, why not spit all this bullshit talking about how you want Randy Orton to test you, you want to do this and you want to do that, then you get the fucking WrestleMania, and that's where you can do the fucking finger poke of doom shit. That's where you can have Randy Orton do the laydown shit. If you want to get Bray Wyatt over as a real mental mindfuck master, that's how you fuck you do it, not the dumb shit you've done the past 3.5 fucking years with the character. But no. This is all about setting up crappy SmackDown main events. Crappy not necessarily in terms of the in-ring action, but just crappy in terms of concept and the gigantic waste of time that it fucking is. So, now we get to the point where AJ Styles is the number one contender. And people actually believe that it's going to be him and Bray Wyatt at WrestleMania. But then awkwardly on that same show, for some reason, for no real reason, just shortly after giving up his opportunity, his guaranteed shot at the title at WrestleMania because Bray Wyatt was the champion, now Randy Orton doesn't like Bray Wyatt. Now Randy Orton hates Bray Wyatt. He hates the Wyatt family. And now he wants his title shot back that he just fucking had a couple weeks ago. And furthermore, from a grand standpoint of it all, just because he said it on TV, based off the way the WWE operates, why in the fuck would that automatically matter and mean that he actually lost the opportunity that he fucking won at the Rumble any goddamn ways? There was no written contract here. There was no contract signing officially handing it over. What the fuck is going on here? So in the span of a couple of weeks, he went from not wanting to face the guy to now he's burning down his fucking house and demanding that he's coming for Bray Wyatt and he's coming for that title at WrestleMania. And all the while, all you're doing, the whole time, the Bray Wyatt concept is supposed to be about a cult leader, a David Koresh type of Charles Manson type of dude. And in 3.5 years, you've done little to nothing to actually make him that type of mindfuck master. But here's Randy Orton, the guy, the Viper, who's not really known for these major mind games, and he's pulling some Undertaker shit on Bray Wyatt to the point where Bray Wyatt's basically in a pathetic heap crying in the goddamn middle of the ring. Where does this make any fucking sense? This really just came out of fucking nowhere. You can sit there and say, setup, there was no fucking setup. And if there was, it was atrocious. And it wasn't logical and it wasn't pieced well together. Because again, this company doesn't know what the fuck they're doing. On top of all of that, now we get to a point in time where Randy Orton's association with Bray Wyatt didn't really bring him much, but it didn't really hold him back from anything. He still was able to win the Royal Rumble. He still had a title shot at WrestleMania. And it's not like Bray Wyatt absolutely demanded that he had to give it up or forced him to give it up. Randy Orton chose to fucking give it up. When this dipshit had the easy way to do it, why the fuck would he take the long circuitous route to get back to where he already fucking was? Furthermore, You're supposed to be behind Randy and cheer Randy, yet he's the one that does the jerk thing by burning down fucking Bray Wyatt's house. Who's the fucking villain here? Who's the guy you're supposed to hate here? Who's the guy that's supposed to get fucking heat here? I'm sorry, but as a general rule, arson is a felony. Those are not people you are supposed to cheer for. We should be talking about that shit. Bray Wyatt should be calling the cops on the dude. He damaged his fucking property. He burned it to the ground intentionally and recorded it for the world to see. But we're supposed to cheer Randy Orton. Holy shit. So then the next week we get back to the spot where he's facing AJ Styles to try and get back the shot at WrestleMania that I'm not really convinced he ever formally lost to begin with that he should have already fucking had. Because all of a sudden, a couple weeks after he apparently loved the dude, now all of a sudden he hates him without there being any real change or real impetus for that type of change in behavior and attitude to have actually occurred. And Bray Wyatt doesn't get involved in the fucking match. That dude just burned your fucking house to the ground and you don't ensure that Randy Orton can't go on to WrestleMania? If somebody burned your fucking house down that represented so much to you, would you let them get to the precipice of achieving a lifelong dream, getting a world title shot, whether it be in MMA or boxing? Now, you're probably going to go in there all irrational-like like Americans do, and you're going to try and blow his fucking head off with a deer rifle or a fucking shotgun. And Bray Wyatt does nothing. And then on top of all of this, what's so crazy about this is you give us Randy Orton and AJ Styles on SmackDown instead of a major pay-per-view, which is one of those really, if you think about it honestly, dream matchups that the internet hardcore community has been talking about for years as being one of those logical matches that they thought make a lot of sense, fit into the dream match category. So, of course, instead of making you pay for it down the road, we're going to give it to you for fucking free with no real build-up and having AJ Styles being the second-bit player. All this did was remind me of how much I would rather see Randy Orton versus AJ Styles at WrestleMania, and how much I resent the fact that they're trying to force Randy Orton versus Bray Wyatt as a world championship match at WrestleMania, and how they're forcing AJ Styles to work with Shane McMahon, so that way Shane McMahon has a WrestleMania match, not that Shane McMahon is working with AJ Styles to ensure that AJ Styles gets the best possible WrestleMania match. That's where the stupidity comes. And the real stupidity comes in at the end of the day of this, is that we spent weeks of television to go from one point to get back to the exact same fucking point. This was not a good story arc. This was not a good anything other than one great waste of fucking time. The dude had his title shot at WrestleMania, gives it up, then wants it back, then has to fight again for something that he already fucking had. What changed so much in a couple of weeks that he goes from loving the dude to hating the fucking dude? It just, if I haven't made the case about how stupid this is at this point, I don't know what the fuck's going to get the point over. And no, don't give me that, give them the benefit of the doubt bullshit, because they don't fucking deserve it. Don't tell me you got to let this shit play out. That's the lame ass answer. And then once you let it play out and you know it's going to suck and it ends up sucking and you try to say the entire time it sucks, then it's the thing of, oh, you're too fucking negative. Or furthermore, it's going to be, well, hindsight is 20/20 and you should have said something. I did say something along the fucking way. So there are a lot of fucking people. But you tried to sit there and deflect. No. This shit is fucking stupid. This story is fucking stupid. About as stupid as somebody on Twitter continually trying to tell me that they actually believe that this match is going to main event WrestleMania. And again, in the WWE's eyes, the main event of a pay-per-view is the match that goes on last, period. Plain and simple. If anybody in that company tells you any fucking different, they're stupid. If any fan or anybody in the media tries to tell you anything differently, they are stupid. The main event of WrestleMania is the match that goes on last, period. And if you think that this match is actually going to close out WrestleMania, you are fucking delusional. This match is much more likely to open WrestleMania, let alone mid-card, let alone be the one that sends the people home. You really think, and at the end of the day, you can say all you want about the part-timer bowl for the Raw Universal title between Brock Lesnar and Goldberg, and I get it. But at the end of the day, you got Brock Lesnar and Goldberg, or you've got Randy Orton and Bray Wyatt. When you were trying to build a show around a world title match, which match are you going to build WrestleMania around? The people with no business sense might say Randy Orton versus Bray Wyatt. The people with some business sense are going to say, yeah, Brock Lesnar versus Goldberg is naturally going to get more mainstream attention. It's going to pique more interest potentially. Could get some new eyeballs on our product. Going to have the most mass appeal. And that's where we're at now. People defending having jobber WWE champions defending their belt at the biggest show of the year. And that's what Wyatt's been. He's a glorified jobber with mic time and a couple of flunkies. What's the difference between him and the fucking job squad? What, the Fireflies? What else? I'm just saying. This whole story between Randy Orton and Bray Wyatt has been stupid. And in particular, the past few weeks, it has been one gigantic waste of fucking time. You literally go from one point again to do an entire circle to come back to the exact same fucking point. Nah, I'm good on this. Y'all can sit there and circle jerk to Bray Wyatt being the champion. Y'all can circle jerk to the story and delude yourself into thinking that the story is any fucking good. It's not. If this shit involved a John Cena or a Roman Reigns or somebody like that, you most certainly know you'd be talking about how shitty it was all fucking day. Because it reeks of all the elements of the type of story a WWE would put a John Cena or a Roman Reigns in, so you'd be right to shit on it. You should be shitting on this too. Because this is crap, and it's terrible, and you fucking know it.